It is always time for history, and I love winches and the history that surround the winches. Let's look back at our older 8274, particularly the brakes. So here we go. This is first generation stuff. This is hailing back into the 70s and into the 80s. So we're getting over 50 years ago now. Okay, now this is easily identifiable as an early 8274 brake. We can see here the small fins on the outside, and it's cast or forged depending on who you speak to. It's repeated on the opposite side as well, and it still retains the same cam drive that we see on the later style winches. However, if we break away and get inside, we find the center disc. Now this is totally different to anything we see today. Now what they used to do, and I know this sounds crazy now, but they used to have individual pucks that used to drop into these holes, and that created the brake. Now actually it wasn't that great, although you think that's a really cool idea. Didn't work very well. They soon went away from that system and they came up with this, which is the later style, which is the solid system. Now they used to use the smaller brake shoes on this. Now if we remember these are the big brake shoes that we use in the 100 series and we use in 8274 today. But back in the day, these used to be a lot slimmer and they used to have absolutely no give in them at all, whereas these are very durable and can be used in oil and grease. Then they also changed the style of the housing. Now, anyone who remembers the 8274-50, and who wouldn't? What a winch! This was the brake that they had, and this is basically the brake that we see today on 8274, and you gotta love it. Worn, forged, USA, everything you need to know. But it's still utilizing the same systems as it was before. So the same keyway drive on the outer, and then on the back, the same keyway drive that we saw for the cam gears. Really cool stuff. Now, back in 2007, when I first started coming out with twin motor winches, I needed a brake for myself. Couldn't use that because that would be wrong, but I wanted something that was very similar, and so we came up with this. This is our three-piece brake. A little bit sexier, I'd like to think, but what we did is just improved a few different things. We changed the material much harder. This is an old one that we've redone, but it just gives you an idea what it is. But what we also did is we changed the number of teeth around the outside, and we went through a lot of effort and a lot of heartache to try and get exactly the right working ratio. The other thing that we found is that this has to be hard. If it's not hard, the teeth wear off very quickly and you're in a world of pain. So then we evolved and things moved on, and these went through several generation changes, and we came over to the 100 series in 2017. Now it was my absolute goal to make everything on that winch as durable as possible, and I wanted to make these in stainless steel, not in mild steel coated with zinc. However, cost is a massive issue when we're trying to take stuff to market, and it just wasn't possible to bring stainless steel to the bed. However, roll on to COVID and things change entirely. I'm very, very pleased to say that we now offer this brake here as standard on all of our 100 series, all of our 50 series and 25 series winches. And the best bit, yeah, you're gonna love this, the outers and the inners are now stainless steel. So, this is stainless, take that away. This is a hardened material, okay, so we don't get any wear on those teeth. And then that inner is stainless as well. So we get much better durability from the brake itself. I love the history. I love everything that goes into making these winches better and better every time we're out. So there we go. Latest generation is on stainless with a hardened center. And thank you for the history with Warren. See you later.